You or someone you love has been diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. And while you might be feeling overwhelmed, lost, angry, or discouraged, there is hope. That hope might come in the form of surgery. Surgical treatment options for pancreatic cancer depend on a few things. If your cancer can be 100% removed for cure, the stage of your cancer and its spread to other parts of the body. If your diagnosis is new or the cancer has come back, the type of pancreatic cancer, your overall health. Surgical options for pancreatic cancer tend to fall under two categories, potentially curative or palliative. Potentially curative surgery comes into play when it's possible to remove all of the cancer. These can be done with open, laparoscopic, or robotic surgery. The Whipple procedure is one potentially curative surgical option. It's also a very complex one. This surgery takes anywhere from 5 to 8 hours and involves the removal of the head of the pancreas, the first portion of the small intestine, and parts of the bile duct and gallbladder. The surgeon will then reconnect the remaining parts so food can move through. Another potentially curative surgical option is a total pancreatectomy. This is recommended if the cancer has spread throughout the pancreas or if there are precancerous risk factors. During this procedure, a surgeon will remove the pancreas, bile duct, gallbladder, spleen, and nearby lymph nodes, along with parts of the stomach and small intestine. However, total pancreatectomies are often avoided because they will cause diabetes. And lastly, a distal pancreatectomy is a potentially curative procedure where the body or tail of the pancreas is removed with the spleen. Palliative surgery is done to ease symptoms or prevent complications like blocked intestines or bile flow. The purpose for this type of surgery is not to remove cancer, but to help improve the quality of life. A biliary bypass is done if a cancer tumor is blocking the bile duct. A surgeon will remove the gallbladder and cut the bile duct near the blockage and sew the cut part to the small intestine. This allows digestive fluid to flow around the area that is blocked. When a tumor is blocking the bile duct, a gastroenterologist or radiologist can place plastic or metal tubes in the duct to restore bile flow. This can be done without surgery. If food can't leave the stomach because a tumor is blocking the intestine just past the stomach, a surgeon can do a gastric bypass. This involves sewing the stomach to the small intestine so you can eat without any problems. There's a non-surgical alternative to this as well. A gastroenterologist can also place a metal stent in the intestine to relieve the blockage so you can eat. Hearing about these options can be a lot, but your healthcare provider will walk you through them and recommend the best solution for you. Don't be afraid to ask questions either. Your needs and concerns are valid. Have open and honest conversations about them with your provider so you can get the peace of mind that you deserve.